for you. Babe, I couldn't find the door.
With the latest thing that Deb and I did, we went and swang.
And yes, we did.
And we snooped. And we found a cabin that had a door ajar. So we went inside, tiptoed in. I had to coax Deb in. And I said, Deb, if you go with me, you'll go a lot of places.
Is there someone living there? Is there someone staying?
Well, we hope. Light
to shining through. But it would not be new if not for you. If not for you, a sky would fall, rain would gather too.
Hi, America. Good morning, America. When you are camping, always make sure that the water goes down before you go. As life goes on, the toilet is now all cleared. Oh, don't anybody use it. Be very, very quiet. Don't anybody use the toilet.
Now, Jane, we could put some flowers in here.
Wouldn't that be cute? I'd love it. It'll be art. We'll put it right by us here, Carolyn.
I have a morning report here at the coffee station.
All is well. We have showers, Vic. Found I found my glasses.
We have teaspoons and 4 teaspoons and half cups and 1/4 cups.
Life is good.
Could hear the robins sing. I just wouldn't have a clue. Anyway, it wouldn't ring. Not for you.
We're on beautiful Lake Neshonoc, and it's approximately 60 degrees. Very, very light wind. Sun is out, partly cloudy. Looks to be a beautiful day. Good day for the swimsuit girls. Over.
Yeah, be very selfish.
Deb, do you have any comments on the sizzle?
Well, Chris says when the sizzle's just right, they're done. So in Chris's honor, everything he grills takes 2 beers. So that's my theory for the hobo packets.
And do you have any commentary?
Certainly. I'm very much looking forward to these. They're such healthy, all-in-one cooking.
Hear the sizzle.
Do you hear the burn?
I've got a sweeter song than the birds in the trees. Well, I guess you say what can make me.
Jules, tell us about your catch. How'd you catch him?
Well, I was sitting here kind of like a lump on the log, and I realized my bobbin wasn't up high enough, so I brought her in, put that bobbin up high, and I immediately, within about 5 seconds, got this little bite. And then I realized, and you know, it's a little hard to set the hook when you're sitting down and being this lazy, but I was able to. And then it was a good pull in, you know, for me. It was great. Bass. He's not a wide mouth, but he's definitely, I think he's a bass, or I even think he's a walleye. I'm thinking he might be a walleye.